what we'll be doing today is rolling this rye here in the background with a what's called a roller crimper, and we'll be showing that in a minute here. The system is called organic no-till because, as many people know, organic is growing at leaps and bounds and everybody wants to get into it. And we are working on the best ways to grow crops, and particularly emphasizing weed management, which seems to be a critical issue in organic farming. So one of the ways that you can help maintain weeds or manage weeds is to use this system called organic no-till. The system was actually developed by the Rodale Institute in Kutztown, Pennsylvania. In 2005, they gave us a roller as part of this national project. And the idea is that this cover crop of rye is planted in the fall. So this was planted last October. And now here we come in the spring and crush it and immediately plant into it the soybean crop. And as the soybean crop grows, the mulch dies down and becomes this protective layer to prevent weeds, but also to help soil quality. So if you look at the soil underneath these organic no-till plots, you'll see that it's a very high quality. It's very rich and crumbly. And if you squeeze it together, it holds its shape. And you can see that there are a lot of roots there too from the rye cover crop. In addition, it's a very high quality as far as organic matter is concerned. It has a very dark color. And we've done analysis looking at the microbial population levels in the organic no-till soil and found it to be much higher than in the conventionally tilled organic soil. We've been doing research on it since 2005, as I mentioned, and we've seen higher soil quality where we use the organic no-till system and lower labor costs because you're not in there tilling. The typical organic soybean system, you use at least four passes for tillage. You'll do two rotary hoeings, two row cultivations, and ideally with this system, if the rye dies down once it's been rolled or crimped, then you won't have to go back with any weed management. Occasionally, you may have to walk your soybeans if you're selling them into the tofu market where they require perfect beans with no staining weeds, such as nightshades. So that may happen later in the season, but early on, we've had really good emergence of the soybeans in this rolled mulch. And one other thing that's really important is to roll it at the proper time. You have to roll it when the rye is ready to die, as I tell people. So it's ready, it's already forming, it's starting to form its seeds, and it's putting out the anthers, as shown here. And this stage is called anthesis. So you want to wait until all the heads of the rye are in the stage of anthesis, that is, all the are showing pollen shed. And once they are at that stage, you can roll the crop and it will stay down. You want it to be a one-pass operation where you wait for anthesis, crush it, and it will stay down. And the objective of the rolling machine is to actually crimp the stems. So when you, at once, we'll see after it's rolled, we can pick up a stem and look how they're all crushed, crimped like that. So it's actually called a roller crimper. And that's the objective, is just to break the water flow between the roots and the stem, and it will stay down, crushed, dead. And within 2 weeks, it should turn into this dry mulch that serves as a protection against the weeds for the rest of the season. So once the roller goes through, you want to make sure you have that uniform layer of cover crop mulch, because if the rye pops up, you may have to roll it again. An alternative to rolling crimping is just to mow the rye cover crop, as shown here with a disc mower, where the rye is mowed at the same stage as the rolling crimping, that is in anthesis, and it should form a relatively uniform mulch. However, many times through the mowing process, the stems are scattered too widely, and if there's any gaps between the rye stems on the ground, that's an opportunity for the weeds to grow. As opposed to with rolling crimping, you have a pretty solid mat or mulch of the rye cover crop that's been rolled crimped, and weeds have a harder time growing through it. Here we are planting the soybean crop into the rolled crimped cover crop or into the mowed rye crop. It's the same principle. And you want to set the planter so that the planting furrow is only wide enough for the seeds to be able to emerge easily, because if you plant it in too wide a furrow, you will have a lot of problems with weeds coming up in that open space. Here you see the soybeans in the organic no-till plots at 45 days after planting, and then the same field at the end of the season. And then in our statistical analysis, we've shown that the organic no-till yields have averaged 20 to 45 bushels per acre, with no statistical difference with organic till plots. In 2014, I conducted a sabbatical study in Italy where I looked at the many variations of roller crimpers, such as the one shown here, where you can see they added on a toolbar two sets of knives that cut through the roll cover crop. And here's a close-up of that knife, which opens up just the right size of a furrow for the vegetable transplants to go in. And today, we're continuing to work on this knife here at Iowa State University and possibly get a patent on it for the U.S.